Oh, and welcome back to Banner Saga. Placed upside down on the ground, the petrified roots of a giant tree reach towards the sky. All the world, including Ivor and Hakon, have separated from the caravan temporarily, giving Baldinger's godstone a wide berth. The giant's presence is missed as you continue to feel watched. Aleo, what do you know about Barting?
Not much, not enough,
the skull says. These flames symbolize Baldinger's love of fire and war, the first being a means to be second. When the Varl were dominating humans in the first great conflict, it was Baldinger who gave those inside fire to combat the giants. You hold up your hand to hold a storyteller, listening through the rain for anything that may be following you. Hearing nothing, Aleo resumes holding the gaze of his audience. Humans praise Baldinger for the gift of fire, but the god only desired more war. He points toward the distant shape of the world. When the giants and humans found peace, the godstone fell from grace. It looks to continue keeping the land scorched. Perhaps its shadow can still kill. Let's step into the shadow. Against Aleo's wishes, you walk directly into the shadow of the godstone gnarled roots. Many clansmen gasp, not caring for disregard. The gods are dead, you remind them. An arrow suddenly sinks in the ground near you.
You're under attack,
shouts Aleo. Shields come up and fire is drawn as you charge the enemy cloaked in the storm. And we are without Val, so that's gonna be amazing. Let's take Hogan, and we have to. The greatest promote. You know, it is not your renown. You will get promoted. Oh, we still have the points. No, you don't. Good. Good, good, good. Okay, that gives us three strength. What do you get anyway? It turns so it's 5-5. Doesn't really matter. It's moving my way. Yep, I think already. Oh, now I can. Thank you. You stand somehow in the middle. The two of you will take care of the archer. Yeah, this is that guy. To get awful close. You just come straight. Okay, that's interesting. Rally gives Wooper. Actually, I don't need Wooper. There's a hit. Oh, weird. Okay. I don't need you to do that. Oh, there's another archer. Maybe not this far. Where?
Oh.
Wait, just came here. Are you sure he wasn't there? Yourself? No, it's mending his armor for armor. She's injured, she's in the bed. Rook is constantly injured. Having killed or run off the cracksman, you return to the remaining cracksman at the custom. Grabbing your belongings, your foot hits something in the mud. You reach down and find a small skull with a yellow ribbon for its eyes. You toss it in the bag without another thought. The rain finally ceases, but the wind picks up. You squint into the gusts and have a clear view of the vast plains ahead. There doesn't seem to be much out there, Ivor says. He His tone conveys wonder and concerns in equal measure. The ground shakes again, and after cause the orcs to strain at their leads in panic. Out here in the plains with nothing but open sky above, you feel remarkably vulnerable. Only a few trees around with no mountains, Hakon says in the right tone. Looks like we only have to worry about the ground opening up beneath us, shrugs at the look you give him.
Grimtar almost looks forgotten by the rest of the world. Maybe those who live here have forgotten the rest of us too.
In a field just outside of Grimdar, the caravan spots several creatures he assumed were myth.
I don't believe it.
Are those? Two horseborn hold simple bronze weapons and stand guard over a few warriors who look long wounded, unable to rise. The size of the caravan makes them nervous.
I have to get a closer look.
Don't this could get ugly?
Maybe, but I've dreamed about putting horseborn scissors as a girl.
All the folks slowly toward the strangers and inform, showing no sign of aggression. They study you but continue glancing around the caravan, occasionally swinging their tails or thumping the ground with their hooves.
I'm Olive, this is Rook. We are here to help if you would like.
The male style swiftness.
Help?
His voice sounds strained, and his mouth moves uncomfortably around the foreign words. Yes, help. Olive steps aside as he waves to Eowyn for help. The female looks agitated and speaks in a long stream of consonants. The male responds to her, then turns to you.
Help. Roek and others.
I'll try. This is certainly a first. The standing horseborn step aside, allowing Eowyn to approach the wounded fighters. With Eowyn and Juno tending to the wounded Roek and other horsemen, the caravan settles down outside the scant town of Grimdar. It appears the town is enjoying a small festival. Quite a few clansmen go over the hill to enjoy the sights and sounds, but soon return looking disappointed.
They called us outsiders, everyone says. They don't want us interrupting their wheat harvesting festival, but the merchants don't seem to mind trading.
The clansmen soon shrug it off and take renewed interest in horsemen, summoning all orders in disgust. Let's visit the market first. See, orders who decide can plus 2 movement, plus 2 strength phases, and plus 3 for the upgrade and another bit. The prince is acting even more standoffish than usual. You and Ivor have caught him staring ahead and twisting the ring on his finger over and over. Ilsa quietly stands nearby. Glad to be heading home? Odin turns to the two of you and offers a word smile.
Even after the chasm, would it surprise you if I said no?
I thought you hated being so far from Arborang.
Life on the trail hasn't worn me over, but it's not all bad. It's even possible that I've learned a few things about leading people while out here.
You, Ivor, and Ursa are stunned to hear the prince talk this way.
I've grown up in comfort and trained with scholars and fighters. I've never known anything else.
Saying stuff like that won't make you any friends in this caravan.
But that's just it. Among the clansmen, I've seen the differences. I think I understand them a bit more.
That's great, Prince Ludin.
I'm glad you think so, but I doubt my father will. Ursa will agree. My father is not what you call open-minded.
The king's hard man has to be, but his son is his weakness. Ludin glares at her, but the archer only smirks.
But can you tell me about King? I suppose, but there's not much to him. He's a king. He draws a hard line on nearly every topic. Talking to him is much like being told what to do. In fact, it's exactly that.
Let's say,
said about me at time that about me at times. This isn't about being his son, you see. Kings usually have to make tough decisions and stick with them. Maybe someday you'll see why. I know, I just don't think he'll care for my ideas on treating people with peasants, commoners. What would you like to be called? We're all people, Prince. Given you. Perhaps you're right. Just keep an open mind about your father the way you'd like him to head toward your ideas. That's something I've never considered before. I'll think on it. As Prince Loden and Ursa walk away, you feel Ivor watching you. What? Do you believe half the nonsense you say? I think I sounded really wise just then. It sounded like you'd be practicing it for a while. That's fair, I'll work on it. Do you share a smell before moving on? That's encouraging. Well, come on in and let's have a look at you, Sven the Dragon said. What can you show me? I don't want more fighters. Knowing how to not hurt yourself, Driven can do that. And show me if you can actively mark prey. So, okay, maybe. Yes, I keep forgetting about that skill. Keep forgetting. Use mark prey to have four allies strike. Use mark prey to have four allies. Okay, how does it work? Does armor break damage? All allies will move to attack the marked target. Oh god damn it. Maybe like this. It's kinda okay-ish. Go over here. I can't get you. What about you hitting? Should have hit one of her. Yeah. Okay, that will make it work. Okay. Do you have smart play? No, I don't have an ability. I think I'd rather have it restarted. Because he can hit some. I can use that. If... No, not for it. I need to rearrange them. I need your help. Should be fine. What my words. If I get you over here, now I'll get you over here. I have no idea what's happening. This guy again. They should make him four. Yay! I found. We can buy that item. I find those easier than the one Boulder.
Those little flies flying around. Let's rest a bit. If it's need to rest for 3 days. Yep. Let's try something else. Maybe there's a connection with me. You held yourself, but what about your other fighters? Ever use a vial in an archer to trap somebody? Yeah. Okay. That's interesting. This is the day we train. Give me. If I'm supposed to use it. Battering ram enemy into rain of arrows. Okay, let's... First things first. Battering ram, how it looks like. This is how it looks like. Okay. Fart message? No. Of arrows like this. So if I throw him away, this, and I will use Ring of Arrows behind him. This. I think it should work. I have no idea what it will work. It will. And it will stop him from moving like that. This is curious. That makes it free. We need to train twice more. Never seen a mender with as much power as the alien. But after watching him a while, but I can show you how to really benefit from the lightning. Thank you! Because I have no idea how it works. Well, I guess it hits all the adjacent, but not in a straight line. Arc lightning a chain of 3 or more enemies. Okay. Arc lightning jumps diagonally. Yeah, that's the word you can do. Mean to me. With each consecutive jump, the damage increases. Wait for your enemies to line up diagonally and use arc line. Well, technically those 3 are diagonally. Technically. So I'll stand here. Hopefully I didn't screw it up. Okay, so just in case I'll move you, so you will be diagonally. Oh, those 2 will get hit or... I think it showed me how it's gonna go. This. Yep. There, Paul wasn't included. Those are quick. I like. I like those training sessions because we can get a lot of renown from it. Mainly that. Like this, we can promote someone. Like Rick, for example. Kulturan is the pole of Luke's welcome, rallies the heroes and calls them to pillage. In pillage there are no more guaranteed talents, scaling and indicates the heroes 2 talents are in a row. The same holds true for the enemy. Sure. Risky, but... Yeah, 20%. Okay, do that. I think I'll give you this eventually, but you lack money. Yeah, I'll give you money. Because you never stand back so far that you can... That's some death and strength over 1. That could be useful for you. But you're not a tank. Super kill strength. What are we making of this? Crit chance. We have 40 crit chance on you right now. Oh, and we have 3 crossbow with us. 17. Okay. We'll be right back. And hopefully, we can train again.
Eventually. Let the last lesson soak in our own. Okay, so
maybe we don't have anything else.
Understandable.
Yeah.
The blown axeman, one of two twins from a small village near Skulker, is dropping into a fallen tree for no apparent reason. His swings look dangerous. Agum, everything okay? He glares at you. Where's your brother, Mugum?
He left with the ravens, wondering if I should have done the same.
Why is that? I've been following your lead for a long time now, and for what?
My brother's gone. My wife and children are frightened of everything around them, including me. I tell them this constant fighting is only for a time, but it's changing me.
I see it in their eyes, in my own reflection. I thought I was doing it to protect them, but if they think I'm a monster, what's the point?
Maybe you should hang up your shield and axe.
He looks shocked by your response.
Really? But what about all the other fighters? I've been laughed at around the campfire.
No one doubts your skills in a fight. Besides, if your family is important, you can handle some ribbing, right?
You're making sense, sort of. Still feels like I can protect them better by fighting.
Depth!
You make big decisions every day. Just make this one for me, will you?
Be with your family. Logan sighs with relief and nods.
I'll still be around, but I'll be busy playing with my kids. You're a good man, Luke.
I'm trying.
Thank.
You glance at Ubin, who snores and smiles.
Scar touch thanks for you
helping his friend, Rorik. Date is the other one, but she's not in talking with her and humans mood.
You're welcome. I would like you to meet Haken.
Skadach tail sweats his flanks and he bows his head towards Haken.
Far man, same her?
No, but we're no longer enemies. I haven't seen Horseborn in centuries. Last they knew to humans and barbar at each other's throat.
What happened to Roek? Roek, brave fighter. Protect food. Hit many times.
Hit? Who was attacking? Skadach says many things in his other language.
Tiki Kenti.
His eyes go wide and he stumps the ground before pointing west. You look at Ubin.
I don't have a clue, but clearly not a friend. Was it the people here in Grimdar?
Scantum looks for Haken is pointing. He shakes his head and points west again. The Dwarf King's eyes scatter suspiciously.
What brings you so far north?
Skadach looks confused by the question, so Ubin shows him the map, pointing to Dadaland and Grimdar.
Food. Our plains.
Break. Haken snorts.
Might be justice. Didn't they kill old horses, Grimdar?
His ancestor did, yeah, but blaming folks for things that happened hundreds of years before they were alive? You may as well accuse these humans around us of starting the Great Wars.
How do you know our language?
Skadar just stares at you.
You talk like us. Where did you learn? Had a little trade with
mans in mud. I think he means bog friends, the cragsmen.
Have you found the food you were seeking?
Enough for time. My guests, two elders take the herkins out.
His hoofs scuff the ground during certain words.
Just those two? What about you and the couple?
Skatach, raw egg, they do stay. This herd help. We help this herd.
That may not be wise. Skadach speaks quickly in his foreign language and kicks his back legs once more.
Not that I'm a translator, but I'm guessing they're all about to return the favor. I think you're stuck with them.
Haken looks at you and shrugs.
No getting around. Demands for honor of honor.
I think this might be a good place to end this part. So for now, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon. Bye.